How do you write great software documentation? Hey there, my name is Josh and I have over 10 years of technical writing experience and I'm also the founder of Technical Writer HQ. In this video, I'll explain how to write great software documentation, the pro tips and tools in order to make it happen as well. But before we dive in, make sure to subscribe to this channel so you can get updated whenever we release new content about documentation from Technical Writer HQ's YouTube channel. Now let's go ahead and dive in. So the purpose of software documentation is to unify the information related to the development of a software project and to provide guidelines that promote discussion of the essential questions that arise between stakeholders and developers. And to write unifying documentation, you need to know what type of documentation approach to take. And the types of software documentation and their scope will depend on the approach the development team has chosen. And there are two main types of approaches here. We have Agile and we have Waterfall. Each approach is unique and they have their own pros and cons. So make sure to pick the one relevant to your company. First is the Waterfall Approach, which is a linear method that establishes different objectives for each phase of the development process. And development teams using the Waterfall Approach tend to spend a lot of time planning a software product from the early stages particularly, and they focus on a long overview of the development process and start creating and writing detailed documentation before the development process even begins. And this type of approach works well for certain companies and certain projects, and they usually have little or no change during the software development lifecycle. It's usually enterprise software and on-premise installation products. However, it's much less effective when it comes to consumer products and freemium software. And that's where the Agile approach comes into play here. It requires efficient teamwork, close collaboration between stakeholders and customers, flexibility, and the ability to adapt to any unexpected changes. The philosophy of this approach is that it's best used for project scopes that change frequently over time. The Agile approach does not need complete documentation from the beginning, but it's always best to start documentation early anyways. And this allows for just-in-time planning. As one of the Agile Manifesto values suggests, it's about putting working software over comprehensive documentation. And the idea is to produce documentation with information that is essential to move forward only when it makes the most sense. Now that we know the main types of software documentation writing strategies, let's move on to the tips of writing great software docs. The first step is to write just enough documentation. You must find the balance between lack of documentation and excessive documentation. Poor documentation causes many errors and reduces efficiency in all phases of software development. At the same time, there's no need to provide a large amount of documentation and repeat information in multiple documents. The next step here is to consider your audience. Try to keep your documentation simple and easy to read. It has to be logically structured and easy to search, so include a table of contents. Avoid long blocks of text where possible and use visual content, including tables, graphs, and charts, as it is often easier for people to absorb information this way, especially data. You should also remember who the document is written for. If it is for the end users, it should be written in simple language so that readers can understand it without having to Google every other word. Now let's move on to the third step here, which is using crosslinks. Crosslink between documents, whether they're product pages or user guides. This will help with proper navigation throughout your documentation and is important to give the reader the correct understanding of a particular topic. The fourth step is not to ignore the glossaries. Software documentation can be dedicated to internal or external use. For external documents, it's best to provide a clear explanation of each term and its specific meaning in the project. Our fifth step is to keep the software documentation up to date. Proper maintenance is very important as documents that are out of date or inconsistent automatically lose their value and can really disrupt the flow of product development. If the requirements change during software development, you must ensure that there is a systematic process of updating the documentation to include the information that has changed. And this is one of the big things I see not happening in software development teams today that needs to happen in order to scale software products efficiently. And the sixth step is to prioritize teamwork. The Agile method is based on a collaborative approach to creating documentation. If you want to achieve efficiency, interview programmers, testers, and other subject matter experts about the functionality of the software. Then after you've written some documentation, share it with your team and get feedback, and make sure to also technically verify it one more time. You can also attend team meetings to stay in the know-how and get firsthand information from the people that are close to the product and close to users. Finally, the seventh step is to pay attention to the details. Software documentation compiles very complex information, so normally there may be errors throughout the documentation creation process. You should proofread your documentation multiple times to make sure everything's in order, and you may also need to edit more than once. Don't rush here. Take it easy and ask others to take a look at your document. Sometimes it takes someone else's eyes in order to detect an error that you may have overlooked. Next is to avoid using screenshots in multimedia unless you absolutely need to. The reason is that it's much harder to update these assets rather than text. Screenshots are often the first part of the documentation to become outdated. Another helpful tip is to consider storing some of your documentation alongside source code. This makes it easier to keep it updated so everyone knows where to access it. Also, keep proper control of your documentation. This means making sure you number your documentation correctly, that you use the correct versions of it, and store previous versions. And you have procedures of how the team should work with the documentation and their level of access. If you're an employer or manager watching this video, consider hiring a technical writer. A tech writer with an engineering background can gather information from developers without requiring someone to explain in detail what's going on. It's also worth embedding a technical writer as a team member, having them participate closely in the software development lifecycle, Scrum, and Agile processes. And the last step here in writing software documentation is to use a document management system. There are countless collaborative tools for software development teams. Those can help to state requirements, share information, and document features and processes. Now let's go ahead and take a look at these pieces of software. You have Atlassian Confluence, which is one of the most popular collaborative project tools that has a whole ecosystem for managing project requirements and writing documentation. And Confluence is known for a stable wiki system and efficient user story management interface. It's not the end-all be-all solution, but it does help. And then we have Document 360. This is a self-service knowledge base software documentation platform designed for SaaS products. And we have Bit.ai. That's a tool for collaborative documentation creation, storing, data sharing, and using a wiki system. The documentation is interactive, meaning that developers can embed blocks or snippets of code right into the document and share it in one click. And once you finish editing your documentation, you can save it in a PDF or Markdown format and post on any other platform. And the last one here is GitHub. For those who are very familiar with software documentation, you already know a great deal about this platform. But for those who don't really know, it provides you with its own wiki system and allows for converting your documentation into compelling website showcases. And there we have it. I hope you learned the ins and outs of how to write great software documentation. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel for more informative content on how to write great documentation and become a great technical writer. And I'll go ahead and see you in some of our following videos. Cheers.